Hello, I'm doing an update right now. I also moved myself over here so I'm not going to be blocking as much text. And so far, I've not had this issue, like, account get banned or suspended or whatever. I'm not sure why the first one did, but I don't know, it might be just caught in the misfire of a ban wave, or I don't know. I'm doing an update though now. Maybe after this update you'll tell me if I'm suspended. I have no idea, but we will see. And then once we get in, I'm probably just gonna quickly do some summons and get into the game. Since last time, we've got a whole bunch of summons to burn through, so let's get to it. We have Jason. Who's this gonna be? Who's gonna be? It's a Lancer. It's Romulus. Saber, Jason, I've come to answer your summons. I may be a hero, but I'm first and foremost a captain. Listen up, never put me on the front lines. Got that? Alright, that's Jason from Jason and the Argonauts. Then we have Romulus, who is the person who Rome is named after. See? He says, I am Rome. And that's it. That's all he has to say. Alright, moving on to the next. Hey! Sasuke Kojiro. I like him. He was in one of the animes. I won't say which, but he was in them and I liked him. I am Sasuke Kojiro, an assassin class servant, and I have been called upon to your service. We have Medusa. You have strange preferences. If you require a sacrifice, do feel free to command me as you wish. Okay, I'll wait for his name. We have Arash. Arash? I don't know. Is his name just Arash? Arash? Alright, what is this guy? Hold on. I am Musashibu Benkei, and I have been reincarnated as a spearman. Best regards. I am Arash, Hero of the East. Nice to meet you. So we have a few more summons we can do. We can try and get Skaha Skadi Ruler, which is wearing a bikini. Okay. We also have Ibuki Doji, a berserker. That would be cool. There's a Lady Avalon still. I don't know who's actually good out of these. We can't do that one. That's a paid thing. I think we go for Skaha Skadi. Getting a ruler would be interesting. Alright, we have not. It's a servant. It's a caster. It's Avis Braun. Let's see what he has to say. Servant caster, I, Avis Braun, have come to answer your summons. This may be a bit early to ask, but would you mind if I set up my workshop? I guess he's like an inventor. I think I knew that. He's like a scientist or inventor or something. We got another servant. It's an assassin. It's someone we already have. Boo. Boo. Oh, a 4-star craft essence. Cruising date. Alright, servant, come on. Alright, it's a caster. Is it Avis Bryant? Nope, it's Mephistopheles. You ever listen to like Trans-Siberian Orchestra? They got some good songs about Mephistopheles. So let's see what he has to say. Oh gosh. Oh, looks like you hit the jackpot, master. I am the devil, Mephistopheles. And I have been called upon. Ooh. Okay, now that's Mephistopheles. Alright, it's a rider. It's Medusa. We already got Medusa. Come on, it's a servant. It's a servant. It's a saber. It's Guile de Ray, I think. Guile de Ray. Guile or Guile? De Ray. One of those. Something like that. he's a Joan of Arc person. He's Frenchman, I think. Saber Gardere, I've come at your request. Is he Joan of Arc? He might have been a crusader that was like exceptionally cruel. I'm not sure. Anyway. Alright, we got another servant. Oh! It's an archer! Who is it? Minamoto no Tamatomo. I'll take it. He's a five star. He's not just a four star, he's a five star. Holy cow. Although he could have been Skaha. God damn it. I would have wanted Skaha. Whoa! Dude's taking up the whole screen. Servant Archer. Anti-military combat unit. My true name is Minamoto no Tamatomo. Standing by for combat, awaiting instructions. Alright, well that's something. Oh, whoa, a five star back to back. Infinity blue sky. There's a craft essence though. Well, I'll take it. Alright, we got another servant. It's a caster. It's Geronimo. Geronimo strikes me as a weird caster. Shouldn't he be an assassin? I feel like he should be an assassin. Servant caster. It is easier to understand if I say Geronimo, right? Over time we'll get so many servants that, you know, we'll have to go through these less frequently. But right now we're just starting out, there's so many servants we don't have. Alright, let's go, we're gonna keep trying to get the Skaha Skadi. We gotta try for it, we gotta try. Come on Skaha! Come on! Skaha! Skaha! Oh. Billy the Kid. Okay, we don't have him at least. It's something new. Not exciting, but something new. Hello! My name is Billy the Kid. Although I'm a new servant, I think I will be useful. Nice to meet you. It's a caster. Oh, whoa! Yeah, that can happen, by the way. Oh! I'll take it! It's Wu Zetian caster. That's one of the event ones. I'll take it. It's not Skaha, but it is something. It is something awesome. Let's see what she has to say. Kufufufu. The perfect, well-proportioned swimsuited me has arrived. She's pretty self-centered. Seems like I'm in my prime now, in a different way. Now that I've remembered my Taoist arts, I have no reason to be afraid of ghosts. Not that I ever was in the first place. Alright, well we got that. Skaha, this is the last chance, at least for now. Come on, Skaha. Come on! It's a servant? Ah, it's a berserker? Alright, Kiyohime. I kinda like her though. I'll be honest, I do kinda like her. I am Servant Kiyohime. Do I not look like a berserker to you? It is nice to meet you, my master. Okay, this is what I'm thinking we do for our team. We've got Mash here. We have Astolfo here. I gave them the Infinity Blue because that seemed like a really good item to equip. But we did have to not have like Watanabe just because you're limited to the costs. Right by my avatar here at the bottom. So we're at 56 out of 56 away. We had to go with someone cheap, so we went with Sasuke Kojiro. And then we also have Wu Zetian here and our robot Archer Man, who I don't really know all that well. I don't really like him as much as a lot of other 5 stars just based on looks. Like, eventually I'm not gonna have this guy on the team, but he is a 5 star right now, we'll keep him on for now. And then you can also see below each character their stats. You can also see what cards they have. So the Astolfo, for example, has 3 crit cards. And this could be very good because you could use all 3 of them potentially and get like insane amounts of assassin like crit points, crit stars, and it could be very good to just have that. But yeah, I think we just need to level them up a bit and we will be ready to continue. All right, so this is the enhancement screen. We choose our person, we choose what embers to give them. And they benefit from having embers of the same type, the same class. Astolfo is a rider, so we're gonna give him, the rider one, rider buffs, and then also, let's see, we can also sacrifice duplicates. Do we have any rider duplicates? We have Medusa, and then we'll throw in these, boost the heck out of them. Here you go. Let's try that. That's a whole bunch. Don't want to give them too much in case they get a bonus on the amount of XP they get. Feel that power, Astolfo. Feel that power. Yay, I've gotten a bit stronger. Alright, so we got Astolfo at the level limit. You can increase that level limit up to 100 before it gets super, super difficult to increase any farther. How you do that is through Ascension, which means we need more of these items than we actually have. So we can't increase it to 50 yet, but Astolfo should be good for quite a while. We should also increase Mash, because Mash will get want. For their ability for quite some time as well. Good work, I've leveled up, Senpai. Alright, we got maxed on Mash for now. Next, I guess we can level up Minamoto no Tamatomo. Alright, I could only get him to like 35. I could also boost him but with the Ascension, but I think we'll probably get another 5 star before I need to do that, and I want to save it for a 5 star that I actually really like. Okay, so good news, I got enough of these statues here to be able to ascend Astolfo. So we can't really level him up because, you know, I don't have enough embers to keep going any further up there, but we can ascend him. So we will do that. And they might change outfits here. Let's see. Whoop. Ascension. Hey, they got a cape. Woo, I can't get enough of this. And they got a new ability that I can upgrade. A chance to inflict stun on one enemy. Not bad. Not bad. Alright, there might be more I can do to buff their abilities and such, but I just want to get into the story again. We need to continue this, so here we go. It says enemy class tendency up here is a Lancer, so it's giving us some Saber people to try. We can go with Attila, I think. Or Altera. I think it's supposed to be Attila the Hun, I'm not sure. We'll have them on our team. Stargazer's teapots. Oh, this is an event thing. Okay. Alright, well, we'll worry about that another time. By the way, the type of being we call servants, you know what they are, don't you? I have no idea. I know nothing from these classes. Just as I thought. It can't be helped. I'll tell you as we move. Think of a servant as the highest ranked familiar in magical world. Various historical heroes, noble acts, concepts, they're all summoned as spiritual bodies. Whether or not a hero truly existed, he or she is still the information that was produced on Earth, right? To summon a heroic spirit is to convert that information stored on this planet into something for the good of mankind. What I think she's getting at is, a servant can be a real person, like, you know, Joan of Arc would be one. Or it could be someone fictional, like, Jekyll and Hyde is another one. So, that's what I think she's mentioning. People today have the right to use legacies of the past, and with that, right, the duty to leave behind a future. What is going on with the music? Anyway. Do you see what you made your contract with is greater than a human, and yet is a tool to serve humans. That's why they're called servants. Even if they're gods, they existed only to serve their masters. Director, your line of thinking may be extreme. May cells not agreeing with what you said. My cells. Blah. Meaning the servant you fused with must be an Earth-type heroic spirit. Servants. Why is that text read?
Servants.
Oh.
Servants are heroes of the past, made into familiars. Those who enter into a contract with them and use them are masters.
There are 7 classes of servants, which vary depending on the servant's legends and abilities. It's incredibly difficult to copy a heroic spirit entirely. Human mages do not have enough resources or memory to achieve such a feat. That's why only one aspect of a heroic spirit is fixed in our world, resulting in the 7 classes: Saber, Lancer, Archer, Rider, Caster, Berserker, and Assassin. Every heroic spirit will manifest as one of these classes. That's wrong. There was an Avenger and stuff. There's other classes. That's the true nature of the servants. It's also a way to hide their true names as well. They hide their names because they are famous. Like, take Achilles from Greek mythology. Achilles is an invincible heroic spirit, but his weakness is extremely famous, right? When a heroic spirit returns, their weaknesses return with them. That's why servants hide their true names behind their class names. If you don't know their identity, it's harder to figure out their past or their weaknesses, right? That's not all. There's another reason for hiding that one's true name. A servant has a secret weapon worthy of their legend. The crystallization of that heroic spirit's miracle and existence. Director! Sorry to interrupt you while you are having fun, but we've detected hostiles entering combat.
Really? Are you sure there's hostiles here? Are you sure, Mash? Maybe try your detection technology again. I feel pretty... feel like there's... You might be wrong.
What? Take them out now. I'll be hiding right over here.
Here we go. All right. So again, we could... I think actually whoever we use will just destroy them. We'll do this. There's one down. I'm not sure if I can fix the leg. There's one thing that I could try that might fix it. I might have to do that. I'm not sure.
I think we want to do... We want to target this one. We'll do that. Then we'll do that. And then we'll do that. Alright. Hey, we got level 2. Cool, cool. Holy cow, is that an 18 achievement things that's gonna inform me about? What the heck? It's gonna be going on for a while. 15? 14? I mean, any one of these is just gonna one shot. Let's go with this character. Nice and neat. Long line. What? Long line. That's my line. Anyway. I can feel the tension across the screen. The director is grumpy as usual. She's not just grumpy. She's a total crank. Well, I can feel some sympathy for the director's ill temper. Excuse me, but Realm Rabbit-senpai, there's too much about Chaldea you don't know. You really think so, Mash? I really don't know what to do with you. It's like you're a lost little kitty. Really? That's what you think of me? Well, not that I'm any different. It's been about 2 years since I started here, and I still don't get it. I kind of sneaked in, almost like an alligator. True, alligators have no clue. Yes, I've learned as much as I can from the database, but I'll share it with you. Chaldea Security Organization, or more accurately, the Security Organization for the Preservation of Humanity, Finis Chaldea, a research observatory with the purpose of continuing and strengthening human history with researchers, scholars, and mages from all around the world. They watch a world that magecraft couldn't observe and science couldn't measure. We're a special organization with national support created to prevent humanity from reaching a bad end. Yeah, I figured. That's what I assumed. Anyway, it's like, oh, really? Ooh. Anyway, that's pretty much it. Ooh. It's true that Chaldea receives financial support from across the globe, but the majority of that comes from the Mages Association in London. From the Animosphere family, Director Olga Marie's family. Chaldea is a research organization, but due to its importance, it operates on a military level. There are extremely strict rules and punishments for everything, so the director's attitude is actually reserved. The director isn't a villain, but she is evil. Wow. Really selling her. She'll get rid of any staff member she doesn't like. Wow. You're really selling her, Mash. Well, I'm not sure if it's okay to call someone who's got a bad attitude evil. She's not a villain, she's evil. Well, she's not evil, she's got a bad attitude. What is it, Mash? What is it? Sorry, I wanted to give you some encouragement, but I'm not used to cheery words. Q, Q, Q. What? Hey! Where are you guys doing? Behind you. The enemy's found us. Prepare for battle. They're so clueless. Senpai, give me your orders. Alright, let's do this. Here we go. Wa-bam. And wa-bam. She's a wizard. Harry. There we go.
んなもんだい。あ、これで最弱の称号はそっちに譲るよ。いいよね。
えい。Seven more things. It's updating me up. It's updating me up so much. Holy cow. Sigh. Please keep an eye on your surroundings. Even if Romani is monitoring us, this is a singularity. There's no telling what might happen. Come here, Kyrolite. You're hurt, aren't you? I can heal something like that. Oh, right. Thank you very much, Director Olga Marie. Well, not really now. When the director is calm, she can be dependable. Well, Mabbit, you should know, the director is in a complicated position as well. Initially, Marie was like you all, a master candidate. 3 years ago, the previous director, her father, passed away, and she had to take over Chaldea when she was just a student. Since it's been one tense day after another, she had taken over as head of the Animosphere family. It was all that she could do to keep Chaldea running. Around that time, an anomaly was found in Chaldeus. We could no longer see that into the promised future of 100 years from now. That was huge criticism from the association and our sponsors. She was ordered to get the situation back to normal as soon as possible. To make matters worse, they found that she had an aptitude to be a mage. The noble Animosphere family, one of the 12 lords, the dominating faculty of astronomy at the Mages Association. Oh, the scandal that would occur if the head of such a family was to be unfit to become a master. You can imagine the level of gossip happening behind the scenes. I'm sure those rumors reached Marie too. Are you talking in front of her? That's a bit weird to say. She still worked to be her best as director. This last half year, she's barely been hanging on. She's worked herself so hard, I'd like her to come for counseling, but with how things are. In any event, she's been emotionally stretched to the limit. She doesn't hate you or anything like that. I was just having fun. I don't really like either of these answers, but I'll just say I was just having fun. Hey, that's not nice, but I understand how you feel. The director wasn't allowed to go out much growing up, so everything she says is honest and innocent. But make sure you don't say that in front of her. She'll just hate you more. Isn't she right here? Anyhow, you're the only one, only three I can trust right now. I want you to continue investigating without fighting. Good luck with that. I got some tank quartz. Don't mind if I do. Alright, let's get Erish Kegel on our team. This one. She's pretty cool. Investigate the port ruin. The hostile life form has been removed. Let's move on. I didn't know what would happen to that with that monster, but I expected nothing less from Sovereign's body. Such power. Not that it makes them look any less scary. By the way, Director, I have a question for you. The Fuyuki and our dad and this Fuyuki are just too different. What happened in the sea exactly? What are your thoughts, Director? I think there's like Fate Zero happened or something like that. Let's see. History must have been slightly disrupted. That's the only reason I can think of. Mash, Realm Abbott, I'm only going to say this once, so listen up. Chaldea observes the future through an Earth model called the Chaldeus. At the same time, a familiar called Laplace compiles past records. You can say it is Laplace's job to gather data. Oops.
on history that wasn't made public, and information that was buried in the darkness that no one knows. According to Laplace's observations, an unusual Holy Grail War was confirmed in the city in 2004, the date World of Warcraft released. I'm gonna say that every time they say 2004 because that's what happened in 2004 to me. Holy Grail War? You mean the Holy Grail from Legend? World of Warcraft? Was it Thunder Fury? Blessed Blade of the Windseeker? Anyway. The magical chalice that is the root of all magecraft? The one that is said to grant its holder's wishes? Yes, that's the one. Mages in Fuyuki City competed for the Grail, and in order to activate it, summoned 7 heroic spirits. That was the beginning of the Holy Grail War. Unknown to anyone, the servants were summoned to this town. The Fuyuki Holy Grail War system is simple. 7 masters fight each other, the last standing gets the Grail. Chaldea learned about this in 2010. My father, I mean, the previous director, used this data to build the summoning system. I think it was during Wrath of the Lich King, if I'm not mistaken. That's what makes up Chaldea's heroic spirit, summoning system fate, our third invention after Laplace and Chaldeus. Third, isn't that the near future observation lens, Sheba? That was created by Professor Lev. Well, I guess you can say we both walked on it. Anyway, this is where the servants come from. 7 servants fought here, and in the end, Saber was victorious. Spoilers. The town was destroyed, and the servants shouldn't have been noticed by anyone, but... Now this is happening. We shouldn't assume that the outcome has changed due to the singularity. The anomaly in 2004, when World of Warcraft released, brought about an alteration to human history as a result. All of a sudden, there were all sorts of gamers in their chairs playing World of Warcraft. South Park even did an episode on it. It was wild. We're no longer able to see 100 years in the future as a result. That's why it's our job to repair this anomaly. Somewhere here is the reason human history has been disturbed. Once we analyze and eliminate it, that will complete our mission. All of us will be able to return to the present. I see, got it. Anyway, although we're not sure what's going on, It's good that the mission is simple. Whoa! You ever watch Yu-Gi-Oh! The Abridged series? I feel like I just did a Joey Weir sound. Okay, anyway. I don't think I could do that again if I tried. Not these guys again. Get rid of the mash, Realm Rabbit. Okay, so the game crashed. We're gonna have to resume it though. Fortunately, it saved where we were, as I expected. Anyway, that was a bit worrying, but everything's fine. Everything's fine. We're good. All right, we're back. I like how Ashki calls abilities. Watch this. Okay, that was laggy, but you get the idea. Big, ghosty skeleton T-Rex. I need to see if I know. I can probably fix the lag. I can probably do it. I'll need to look and do it. Oh. There we go. I'll just do that. Hey, we got level 3. Good. Levels allow us to basically boost the amount of servants we can have, or like craft essences, that sort of thing. So it is
useful to be leveling up. You can get a better team that way. I think we'll end this episode here. Next time we'll finish this, and I think we might get a... We might get something from this chest. It might be a Holy Grail, it might not be. I think it might be too early, but... I don't know, it's a box, it could have anything, it could be a boat. We don't know, but we will know next episode. So, till then, goodbye. And I probably won't have the leg fixed by next episode, but maybe the episode after, we will see. We will see. We will see. Till then, goodbye.